October of this year. One of the guys you listen to throughout this tournament, Mike Johnson, who'll call the games with Gordon Miller. A lot of players to watch on Finland, including Konsta Hellenius, who's draft eligible, has 20 points in 28 Liga games so far. Craig Button has him fifth on his draft list, but a lot of his Finnish teammates saying he should challenge Macklin Celebrini to go first overall. What makes him special?
Well, they might be slightly biased, James, as his teammate. But, yeah, what makes him special is that he's a complete player. As a young player, he's got a very mature game. He doesn't stand out. He's not the biggest, might not be the fastest, but he does everything well. Finds himself in really good spots. He's strong on the puck. He's feisty in battles. James, he's stepping in on Team Finland as an underage player. He is the number one center on the number one line with that kind of production in the top Finnish league. So, really, it's his brain, his positioning, his competitiveness will really stand out for him. He's going to have a great tournament. Then Finland will have a good chance to go deep.
And Mike Johnson and Gordon Miller on the call in just a few minutes. Canada certainly has an advantage, as you expect, as far as the draft goes. 9 first-rounders for Canada, and then 7 more from the second and third rounds, plus presumptive number one overall, Macklin Celebrini. Finland, 0 first-rounders, although Hellenius will change that next year, and 9 second- and third-rounders, 3 first-year eligibles, including Hellenius there. One guy who has a lot of experience with Team Canada is the coach, Alan Letang. 2 golds as an assistant at the World Juniors, 2 more coaching at the Hlinka Gretzky. He's with Kenzie.
Well, Alan, this time last year, you were behind the bench with Team Canada in Halifax, Nova Scotia. Now, here you are as head coach leading this group in Gothenburg, Sweden. So from your perspective, what is the best part about game one, day one at the World Juniors?
Yeah, I mean, I think it was a little bit of yesterday, watching the kids' faces come in and realize this is going to be our home for the next, you know, few days. And they see the room, they see all the excitement, they've got all the headshots, they get their credentials. It's a fun day for them. And then you come today, you know, it's nice having the afternoon game. I don't think there's a whole lot of build-up for our guys to sit around and wait. So I think it's going to be exciting. They all walked in, big smiles on their face, probably a little bit of nerves and excitement, but that's the whole point of it, right? If you're not nervous, then you really have nothing on the line then, and so it's good.
In a short-term tournament like this, it really becomes a race to see which team can find chemistry the quickest. Are you pleased with what you've seen from your group so far?
Yeah, I mean, I think we built every game we played. You know, we flew over, we had a plan for our jet lag, played a game against the Danes. I thought we played well. Got a little bit of a tougher game against the Swiss. There were some pockets there where, you know, we take our foot off the gas, and it's good learning. Like, every team is competitive. Every team marks the calendar for Canada, so we're going to get their best, and it's important for us to come out shift after shift. And then we have a real good, physical, emotional, tight game against the U.S., and I think it's prepped us for this because this game is going to be no different.
You talk about learning. I mean, for a lot of these players, this will be the first time they'll wear the Maple Leaf on the international stage. So what will be the message to those guys here today?
I think just enjoy it early on. Right, a lot of these kids got missed out on the Hlinka. A lot of they missed out on the U17 based off of, you know, COVID and all those other experiences. So I think they need to take it in, but they need to know that it's going to get real fast, and we're going to stick together and trust each other.
Thank you, Alan. Good luck.
Thank you.
All Swedish music during this World Juniors. So ABBA, take us to break.
Can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. Wish that I could stay forever this young, not afraid to close my eyes. Life's a game made for everyone, and love is the prize. So wake me up.
Thank you, Avicii. There's Connor Geeky, one of 22 first-timers for Team Canada in Gothenburg, Sweden for the World Juniors. Fraser Minton has never worn a Team Canada sweater at any level, and he'll wear the C in the opener today against the Finns. Three gold medals in the last 10 years, but underdogs again today against Team Canada. As we say, hello, Canada, happy Boxing Day, and welcome to our favorite event of the year. It's the 2024 World Junior Hockey Championship. James Duffy back alongside two-time Olympic gold medalist Cheryl Pounder, 1995 World Junior gold medalist The Goods, Jeff O'Neill, and a man covering his 36th World Juniors, one Bob McKenzie. Here's a couple of unanswered questions for Team Canada. Most of all, how do you follow the last two tournaments? That McTavish save and Kent Johnson with the golden goal in the summer in Edmonton. And then last year, Bedard's historic performance and Dylan Gunther with another golden goal against Czechia. None of that matters. This Canadian team trying to win a third straight gold medal. And the starter today, game one against Finland on that long road to gold. To get you ready for it, Gordon Miller and Mike Johnson.
And James, so much talk before this tournament about who wasn't here for Canada, but here's who is a very deep group.
Well, and that's just it. There might not be a superstar. There's no Connor Bedard, but what Canada wants to do is wear you out with their depth. You look at their sentiment. You got Patra. He's returning from the NHL. He's got to play. You got Celebrini. He's going first overall. He's going to play. You have Geeky, who's one of the best players available. He's going to play. And, oh, yeah, Owen Beck, the only other returning, is a fourth-line centerman. They will roll four lines almost one after another the entire game at 5-on-5, and there will be different heroes that emerge every single game, but they won't count on any one line, any one player. Each game will write its own story, but they like their depth. They think they can be better further down the lineup than the opposition in this tournament.
These teams did not face each other last year. Their last meeting was memorable. It was in Edmonton in August, the World Junior Championship. Kent Johnson, the golden goal after the Mason McTavish play, the first of the two back-to-back gold medals that Canada's defending here in Gothenburg.
Exactly 1 year ago today, we all sat in Halifax. Opening day, everybody pumped, the crowd pumped up, and Canada loses 5-2 to Czechia in front of a stunned crowd. How do they change that in the opener this year?
You got to earn the coach's trust right off the hop, James. MJ just talked about rolling over four lines. That's a big thing for Canada. They want to overwhelm the opponent, get on their forecheck, straight line hockey, as every coach says. But if your line is going out there and turning the puck over and doing negative things to help your hockey team, the coach is just not going to put you out there. Also, role acceptance. These guys all play 20-plus minutes for their team. You might not play that much, but you got to make an impact every time you step on the ice.
And one of the things I'm certainly looking at is the big ice, right? Mm-hmm. I think against the United States in particular, in the first and the second period, the defense got caught outside the dot. So you saw breakaways, you saw odd man rushes. So I think it's going to be in particular critical to make sure that they're pushing to the outside. Players like Denton Matejczyk, he's a skater, he's offensive, so he's going to have to lead from the back end, puck possessed. But then you've got the size and someone like Maverick Lamoureux. And here's a guy who is going to have to be able to transition skate in the neutral zone. But once in, he's going to have to stay between the dots, not get caught chasing and push to the outside.
Spotlight is always brightest on the man between the pipes, and that will be Matisse Russo, Halifax Moosehead, a goaltender, 5'11", passed over in two consecutive National Hockey League drafts, will try to forge sort of the same storyline as Tomasz Milic did a year ago as an undrafted 6-foot goaltender. So a lot of pressure on Russo in this game. The other guy who's under the spotlight, Macklin Celebrini, presumptive number one overall pick, and boy, this kid can really play. You don't want to put too much pressure on a 17-year-old at the World Junior, where it's supposed to be a 19-year-old tournament. But boy, he was really good in the pre-tournament.
And I mentioned Finland, who over the last decade has reestablished themselves as a legitimate contender every year at this tournament. This is the 10th anniversary of them beating the Swedes in OT to win gold, the last time the tournament was held in Sweden. Drop of the puck next.
The 2024 IIHF World Junior Hockey Championship is proudly presented by TELUS.
They've made the trip to the city on the west coast of Sweden to see the 2024 World Junior Hockey Championship. We've got three Swedish officials. The referees are Daniel Eriksson and Tobias Björk from Sweden, and the linesmen Anders Nyquist and Lucas Rampier. 19-year-old Matisse Russo from Beaubriand, Quebec, gets the start for Canada. His first time playing for Hockey Canada. He led the Quebec League with a .934 save percentage with Halifax when he left for the Canadian camp. The pre-tournament, a bit of a struggle for him, under .890 in three appearances. Nicholas Kokko is a Seattle second-round pick. The 19-year-old plays for Carpat in Finland's SM Liiga. And there is the gold medal magnet, Alan Letang. Four tournaments for Canada prior to this, four gold medals. Three as an assistant, one as a head coach at the recent Hlinka Gretzky Cup. And Lauri Miikkala, first year as the head coach of the Finnish national junior team, was an assistant coach last year. And there's lots of Finns in attendance as well. 11 days of hockey that provide memories to last a lifetime. And it starts with Canada and Finland. And here we go. Canada's defense of the two gold medals is underway as it's fired in by Denton Matejczuk. Canada's defense core, as James Duffy talked about, upended prior to this tournament. Two players had to be replaced due to injury. And now brought right back in. There's a chance in front for Connor Geekie on the feed from Fraser Minton. And behind the goal, battle for the puck, Jordan Dumais. Burns that free for Minton, back at the point for the hulking Maverick Lamoureux, 6'7" Canadian defenseman. Bounce along the boards and racing back is Lamoureux, an Arizona first round pick, one of the three first round picks in last year's NHL draft. And here is Geekie with it. Scoring star for the Wenatchee Wild of the Western Hockey League, Winnipeg Ice. And Geekie trying to work that free for Easton Cowan. That one knocked down. The puck played back to center ice. Scooped up there by Aleksanteri Kaskamaki. And the lead pass walking right in. A great chance rolled wide there for Jari Lassila. And now Canada back the other way. It's Cowan. In on Pietaniemi. And Cowan gets a shot away that's steered away by Coco. Loose puck in the Canadian zone. And played right through the crease. And quick with that was Noah Warren. Cowan battling for it. Throws that back. The pass is picked off and moved ahead by Rasmus Kupalainen. Finns finished fifth last year, lost a heartbreaking quarterfinal game to the Swedes. The game was tied 2-2 just 4 minutes ago. The Finns were on the power play, gave them a shorthanded goal, and their arch rivals from Sweden beat them to advance to the semis. And Owen Beck back with it, the only returning player for Team Canada, a late addition to last year's team. Plays it out to Nate Danielson. This line will get lots of work for Canada, usually playing against the other team's top players. Finns are in this game, though. And a big hit by Beck behind the Finnish goal. They're going to call a penalty here. Yes. And it's Beck who will go off.
Big hit by Beck on a forecheck. He doesn't like it one bit. You're going to see an awful lot of this. Canada on the forecheck. I guess it's in the numbers as Väisänen is watching his pass. And there are some nerves early. Noah Warren, oh boy, little heel pick. And Lassila a chance there. It's quite natural to be a bit nervous to start this tournament.
And the Finns will go to the power play here. 2 minutes and 10 seconds into the first period.
Maybe the lesson for Beck is if you're going to get someone around the edges, it can't be that hard.
Emil Hemming, a 17-year-old, on this top power play unit for the Finns. Mulanyomi plays that back around, walking right in.
And Hultonen
couldn't get it. Now a shorthanded bid for Canada. Right back by Braden Jaeger, moves it back in front and just out of the reach. And his teammate, Denton Matejczuk, the defenseman, was way up into the rush for Canada. Matejczuk did not have a point in his last game before leaving for the camp for Moose Jaw. That ended his 23-game point streak, the longest in the CHL by any skater this year. Now gathered up by Oiva Keskinen. And the Finns will settle things back down on their first power play of the tournament. 6-2 Slovakia on the Czechs in the early game. And Slovakia served some early notice. And here is the youngster that so many have come to see, Konsta Helenius, number 19, wearing the full cage. Helenius projected to be a top five pick in the upcoming NHL draft. Back at the point, Jani Newman plays it back in the corner for Hamanaho, a returnee from last year. Kaskimaki plays it back for Newman. To the point, he goes to Karki. Kharky plays it across. Helenius has it tipped away. And now a race for it. Here comes Jaeger shorthanded again. That's chopped away by Kharky. Picked up now by Danielson moving in. Nate Danielson gets a chance and it just rolls off his stick.
Really good stick by Geeky, working the seams, poking pucks loose.
30 seconds to go on this finished power play. Kharky plays for Sault Ste. Marie in the OHL. More than a quarter of the players in this tournament on the 10-team rosters play in the Canadian Hockey League. Six of the Finns play in North America. And that long shoot-in gathered up by Cowan. Looks back down to Allard. Owen Allard slides that back as time winds down in this finished power play. Here's Matejczuk with it. And Matejczuk, first round pick of Columbus, pivots back, throws that through the middle. It's picked off and brought back by Kalle Kangas. In shoots, club by Rosselli. He'll hang on to that. No shots for Finland on that first power play.
And so much pressure on the goaltenders in this very short tournament. Matisse Russo having a fantastic season. Yes, he's draft eligible. He hasn't been drafted, largely because in today's NHL, it's too short.
5'11".
Had he been an inch or two taller, he'd be drafted by someone, but he's got the right mentality, a lot of confidence and self-belief that he's the guy to get the job done for Canada.
He's 16-3-2 this year for Halifax. He won his first six starts of the year. You mentioned went unpicked through the last two NHL drafts. Shades of last year, Thomas Milic, the same story for Canada. After winning a gold medal, was picked in the fifth round by the Jets, his third time around. Matt Poitras added to the Canadian lineup for the Boston Bruins after the selection camp. And a big boost to this Canadian lineup. Now dug free by Koskipirti. He's bumped in the corner by Jorian Donovan. Pick free by Savoy. Moves out ahead for Carson Rakoff. In comes Poitras. Slides it back in the highest lock. Quick chance for Savoy, and the save is made by Coco. Great look there for Canada early on.
Really well-executed rush for Canada. Center lane drive, slide it wide, and look to create triangles. Rakoff drives it in, and Poitras, look at the vision, kicks it back. Savoy stops as Finland over back checks. Everyone drawn down on the net. Savoy finds the soft area, and that's where he is at his best. Good save by Coco early in the game.
Coco's playing for Carpathia, the Finnish SM Liga, their top league at the age of 19. And here is Helenius for the defensive zone faceoff. He wins it. Yemi. Kept alive and a long shot by Ty Nelson. Rebound bounces back in front. And say hello to Ty Nelson, who loved to shoot the puck. He led the Ontario League in shots on goal last year, not just by defensemen, but by all skaters. He had 296 in 65 games.
No better way for his first touch to be than a point shot.
Scored 24 goals last year for North Bay.
Gonna shoot that much, you better put some past the goaltender. What an adventurous 24 hours. Got in late yesterday, slept all night, and good to go today.
Winding back in, a little behind the back play there. Lifted wide by Lenny Hamanaho. And played back down to the finish zone. Artu Kharky goes back for it. Vegas third round pick. And Lamoureux threw down his man as he slammed down Yanni Nakarita at the line, and play was called offside.
Maverick Lamoureux, you cannot miss him. He's so big out there, 6'7". He's going to try to bring a physical presence to the game. And anytime you can get a good hit on, he will. After this very slick rush by Hamanaho, New Jersey prospect. And there you go, big reach, finished with the hit as well. Why not? Sending Nakarainen into the offense, don't cause the offside. Picking your spots to be physical will be key, though. You can't run around and chase hits. They have to present themselves to you, especially on the big ice.
Later tonight in this arena, Sweden will take on Latvia. The host Swedes have high expectations this year. They hosted this tournament last 10 years ago as that slides wide, icing waved off. They lost the gold medal game in overtime to Finland. A bitter defeat. Tough enough to lose a gold medal game on home ice, but to lose it to Finland was extra tough. That was Rasmus Ristolainen with the golden goal. Matejczuk pivots at the highest blue line, shoots, that's kind of punched away by Coco, who's leaning into that shot. Allard with it now. Allard tried to center it off the back, and it goes. And Minton had that taken away. High in the air and back out by Kasper Holtonen. Plays for London in the OHL. Good friend of Canada's Easton Cowan. Oliver Bonk, the son of longtime NHLer Radek Bonk, played that ahead. It's knocked down and Russo's back out to play it. For Bonk. Plays for London in the OHL. A Philadelphia first round pick. Lamoureux up ahead to Beck. And Owen Beck. Quickly ahead to Allard, sliding in. Allard back for Danielson. Danielson shoots. Coco save. Rebound. Tap wide there by Allard. Bonk moves it back in. Here's Allard loose in the corner. And Allard plays that back for Bonk. Shields off his man. Plays it back in. Now the rink wide pass goes to Jesse Pulkkinen. Bounce back down to the game zone. Bonk goes back. And Oliver Bent. Bonk tied up in the corner. Beck comes in to help him out. And Jurrien Donovan with it. His dad, Sean, a gold medalist for Canada at the 1995 World Junior Championship in Red Deer. He made it. Jeff O'Neill. And here's Bonk with it. Bonk pivots back, being pressured there by Samu Bao. And the puck moved back the other way. Canada needs to change. Here is Beck, sends it back in. And look at fresh legs on the ice. Cowan causing all kinds of problems for the Finns. They're trying to knock that freight. And Joona Väisänen with it now. Moves it back to center ice. Now chipped ahead. Cowan goes after it. Cowan tied up in the corner. Tries to one-hand that back. It does for Savoy. Now played back. Potras drops it back. Savoy with a chance. It pinballs around in front. Out of the reach. And now move back in. And pass there by Noah Warren just missed. Back down to Cowan. Cowan tied up. Tried to kick that free. Potras comes in. Here's Savoy. Matt Savoy in for Potras. Good pressure by this Canadian line. Potras slides it back to Warren. So Warren shoots. It's blocked. Goes right back to him. Tries it again. And that's kicked out by Coco. Bounce back down. There's a way out the play. The Finns are changing. A quick up now. Savoy. Matt Savoy shoots. That's wide of the goal. Jumping in. That bounced away from Matthew Wood. Brought back by the Finns. Hard shot. Rousseau steered that away. Loose at the side of the goal. Two Finns collided there after the shot by Hamanaho. And brought back by Wood. Matthew Wood in. Shoots. It's off a stick. Up and out of play. No score here in the first period. It's day one of the 2024 World Junior Hockey Championship. Crunch time in Gothenburg. Finnish fans have made the trip. They're outnumbered by the Canadians who have come here from all across Canada to take this in. It's become a tradition for a lot of people to go every year the tournament's played in Europe.
It's amazing around town, around our hotel, to see the amount of red and white. It's a long way to go, and it is several thousand.
Off the faceoff, Macklin Celebrini winds it and shoots it, but just wide as Coco got a piece of that. Say hello to Macklin Celebrini, a 17-year-old, a star this year in his freshman season at Boston University, projected to be the number one pick in the upcoming NHL draft. And they're not easing him into this lineup at all. Now a centering pass just missed Matejczyk, who jumped in again. And Matejczyk gets a stick on that. Jaeger has that knocked down by Kaskimaki. And Kaskimaki plays it back across for Salad. Picked off at center ice by Celebrini. Poked that head for Jaeger. In comes Braden Jaeger. Shoots. He fired that just wide. Wood back on it. Celebrini's tied up at the blue line. Finn had a hold of his leg as he was tangled up there with Jari Lassila. And Celebrini with a word for the officials as he goes off.
You gotta let him hold me. I'm gonna keep cross-checking him in the back, apparently.
Amopian Yemi moves out ahead. Banks back around. As Jordan Dumais got a stick on that. Only Connor Bedard had more points in the CHL last year than Jordan Dumais, who was the Quebec League MVP. Minton tried to tap that back, but it's picked off and brought back to the other way. Yanni Newman. A Seattle second round pick. Newman plays that ahead. It's knocked down by Bonk. Off the side boards, bottled up and played back in by Keskinen. Great pass and dumped on the play was Rakoff. Now Geeky jumping in. And the lead pass went off the skate of Emil Hemming. Tap back by Nelson. He got the very late call to join Canada. He was in Pittsburgh, went to a Penguins game. The next day he was going to a Steelers game. His family are lifelong Steelers fans. And as they were leaving the hotel, he got the phone call. We need you. So back in the car, 5-hour drive to Toronto. Pack, go to the airport and get here.
Thank goodness they hadn't gotten to the tailgate section yet.
Yes.
Would have been a tough drive home.
Beck knocks that down. Owen Beck winds it back in. Won a OHL title with Peterborough last year. And played the Memorial Cup after being traded by Mississauga. Warren gets a stick on that. It's tapped back for Jake Furlong, the captain of the Halifax Mooseheads from Upper Tantallon, Nova Scotia, just west of Halifax. Back down to the finish zone. And Beck comes in again. Beck got that early boarding penalty. And here is Hellenius. Had a stick lifted there by Rakoff, who lifts it back to center ice.
Pass to Tony. Good job protecting the middle of the ice right now, neutral zone.
And a steal there by Potras. Up for Savoy. For Potras. Walks right in and shoots, and a glove save by Coco. Best look for Canada yet. And Matt Potras turned away by the Finnish netminder. No score here in the first period.
And the Lost Kingdom, now playing only in theaters.
Canada's best chance have come from this line. This time it's Savoy dropping to Patra, who basically has a breakaway on the turnover. In alone on Coco, just doesn't elevate it quite enough. Nice glove save by Coco, but Canada will love to see that defense turning pucks over, leading to quick strike offense.
And they stay out for the TV timeout. Benyemi moves out ahead, but Patras forced the turnover at center ice. And here is Matejczak. Banks ahead for Savoy, just out of his reach. Savoy, the first overall pick in the Western Hockey League draft in 2019. There's a steal by Savoy. Walks right in. Savoy shoots. Coco save with the rebound. Batted away by Hamanaho. Sends it down the ice. An icing call against the Finns. Another good look for this line.
Savoy will be disappointed in this shot. He fans on this puck. He's got great hands. Tremendous release. We've seen it all week long. We've seen it in junior. He gets the turnover here, and I think he catches the top half of this puck. He's trying to slip this one five-hole, maybe for a rebound. Doesn't quite get all of it. You see him heel it. And, another one-on-one with Coco, who looks good as well.
Oliver Bonk with it. Slides the puck along. And Donovan plays it in. The rosters declared last night, 20 skaters and 3 goaltenders. Players can be replaced if a federation applies to the IHF for medical reasons, but that's the only way you can replace a player. So the World Championship is 22 skaters and 3 goaltenders. Now that's brought in and fired by Kangas and off the leg of Bonk. Kangas back with it, shoots again, and the glove stop made by Rousseau.
I think it's important for Russo just to get some positive touches. It's been a pretty quiet period. Not a lot of chances, not a lot of good opportunities against, which is good. But he wants to just feel good, start building the confidence that he has come into the tournament with, given his solid performance to start the season.
Johnny Newman, a returnee from last year's team for Finland. They've got 8 back. They've got, 5 returning. 8 can return next year. They've got a real young team here. So 8 players born in 05 or later for them. Right off the draw, there's a chance, and the backhand shot fluttered there by Samu Bob. Back along the boards, jumping up is Kelly Kangas. Keskinen trying to dig that freight. Now moved back by Kulnyomi. That bounced away, and a race for it now as Jordan Dumais comes in. And racing back was Kangas. Dumais wins the battle for the puck. Here's Dumais back with it. Laid back around and picked up behind the goal by Geeky. Throws it back to Warren with a shot. Coco the save and the rebound just out of the reach of Minton. We have a Keskinen back with it. And Rousseau out to play it. Chips it around to Warren. Noah Warren. Slides it back across. That pass almost picked off there by Bow. A battle in the corner. Here's Bow with it. Plays that back to Pieniemi. Right back to Karki. Karki spins and shoots. Rousseau the stomp, and the puck steered to the corner. Furlong after it. And the 3 Halifax Mooseheads on this Canadian roster as Cowan goes back. Now back at the point, picked up by Koskupirti. That's picked off and almost off the races there with Savoy again.
Batra coming off the bench, got lost on the line change.
Karki plays it back around, that's picked up by Savoy. Matt Savoy for Patra. Patra moves it up high. Patra spins back again and leaves that back for Lamoureux. Goes that towards the goal. That floated just wide. And Patra has the puck just out of his reach as the puck goes back to center ice. Inside five to go in a scoreless first period. Lamoureux being harassed there by Hellenius, who plays for Ukrainian in the Finnish top league. In comes Patra, leaves it there for Savoy, backhand shot, another great look for this line, and Coco once again turns it away in a scoreless first period.
It calls you to a place with no boundaries, where the trail ends and the beyond begins. The Chevrolet Silverado ZR2, built to take you where the trail ends, so you can go beyond.
Stream the biggest event.
Gold in Vancouver in 2019, three gold medals in the last 10 years for the Finns. They won on golden goals in 2014 in Malmo, in 2016 in Helsinki, a celebration that might still be ongoing. As far as we know, one loss, though, for the Finns. They did not get Jochen Kemmel, first-round pick of Nashville. He's playing for Milwaukee in the American Hockey League, and differing accounts whether he chose not to come or was
encouraged.
There's a long shot by Bob, triples it behind Coco, and that's picked up there by Pulkkinen, and that almost found its way in. Bonk back across to Nelson. Jaeger had that taken away. Pulkkinen looks back in front. Great chance, played across. Oh, what a stop by Rousseau! Matisse Rousseau with highway robbery in the Canadian crease. What a stop!
Oh my! Welcome to the tournament. Turnover, 2-on-0. Haminaho got a wide open net. Rousseau reads the pass. You see him loading up. Oh, oh my gosh. The left hand comes out. He loads up the right leg. He's reading pass. But man, oh man. What a save. Save of the tournament.
The first period of day one. Wow. Off the draw. That shot taken by Hultonen was blocked. And back comes Canada. Beck.
He's got Beck again.
Beck back in front, shoots it. Cook on the stop on that. Allard lays it back for Beck. Matejczak back around for Lamoureux. In the high slot, that shot lifted high and wide by Allard. Back around is Beck with it. Beck in for Allard to Danielson, the Detroit first rounder. Danielson slides that back. Matejczak has a look. And Matejczak pivots away again from Koskimaki. Plays it back for Lamoureux with a shot. Rebound score! It got through Coco and Canada opens the scoring. Looked like Nate Danielson got the last touch on it. And Canada's got a 1-0 lead.
What a swing. The save in one end. Moments later, Lamoureux, patience to wait and take it to the far side of the net where the body is. And Nate Danielson working in front, trying to get open, finds a way to get a piece of his body on that puck. And it goes right through his jersey, off his pants, and down through the legs of Coco, who has been really sharp in this first period to open the scoring for Canada. A well-deserved first goal.
Ordinary Day by Great Big Sea is Canada's goal song this year. More Atlantic Canadian flavor.
Kind of replicate after, from last year.
After Heave Away from last year. And then given the goal to Lamoureux, but that'll be changed. And announce it as Danielson. So quickly change that scoring, and Canada's got the early lead. Furlong back for it. Out to center ice, chipped in by Minton out there with Geeky. And Dumais. Oh, almost stolen there by Minton, who was heading back the other way.
Do I take the puck or do I just hammer the guy? He elected don't risk a penalty.
Rink wide pass by Geeky. Finds Dumais. In comes Warren with a centering pass, and that was blocked by Rasmus Kumpalainen, Minnesota's second round pick. As the puck bounces off the sideboards and back to pick it up is Bonk.
One thing we've seen already in this first period is Canada's forwards can beat the Finnish defenders up the ice.
And here comes Dumais with it. Dumais walks in, drops it back, and that shot hammered wide by Cowan. Back at the point is Bonk. And Bonk was tied up there by Bow, but it's stolen back by Cowan. He fans on the shot, and Bow has it back. Canada with a wide edge in shots here in the opening period. Brought in by Koskipirti. He plays at Michigan Tech in the NCAA. Brought back across the top by Emil Hemming. Hemming still with it. Throws it back in front. That pass was ticked away by Donovan. Donovan back around for Bonk. And Bonk gets it high at center ice. Skipping puck. Cowan trying to hunt it down. It's picked up by Salin. Otto Salin moves that ahead. Donovan hustles back and takes that away from Hamanaho. And Canada back 3-on-2. Patra.
The hook.
And it's going to be called. Canada's going to get his first power play here as Rousseau makes his way off. And the extra skater comes on. It's Celebrini. So a late power play here for Canada. And the power play was dynamic last year. 14 of 30. Nearly 50%. Celebrini comes in. The puck finally touched up there by Pulkkinen, and Canada with 1:19 to go in the first period gets its first power play of the tournament.
So Canada will look to extend on their lead. Patras had a fantastic first period. Obvious hook there by Nakarainen as he gets body position. Here's the goal. Matejczuk biding time. Lamoureux wisely gets it far side, fighting in front of the net. And he'll take a goal any way they come right now. Nate Danielson off the pants and in. Great opportunity here late in the first to extend to a two-goal lead.
Second-year captain of the Brandon Wheat Kings. Danielson, a Red Deer, Alberta native. So the power play goes to work with Celebrini at center. Wins that face-off back to Matejczuk, but not done fairly.
They get possession, be on the lookout for the slap pass from Celebrini down to Geeky in front of the net. We've seen it work many times for goals or good chances. Like a fake one-timer to Geeky on the far post.
Celebrini got tossed from the face-off circle, so they'll move back to the point, and Minton will take it. Canada has a number of natural centers playing the wing, and Minton wins that face-off cleanly back. Matejczuk back for Celebrini, shoots, and his stick flew up on it. That gives the Finns a chance to send it down the ice. And here's Matejczuk with it. Picked up by Minton. Final minute now, the opening period. Here's Dumais. Jordan Dumais back across. Celebrini, there's that slap pass looking for Geeky, and it just missed.
So Celebrini's playing on his offside. Puck kind of runs through him. One way to soften up coverage is to shoot early, even if you're going to pass it later. Now, of course, his stick blows up. That doesn't work, but this one absolutely right, Gord. This is going far post. There's Geeky there for the tap in. Good stick from Pulkkinen to take it away. I don't know if that's another scouting, but that is a play they look to all the time.
Now, Geeky will take the face off on this side of the ice.
Let's turn his stick over, take it backhand.
How about that? Now, loose puck in front. Quick chance there for Celebrini. Was blocked. Puck bounces high in the air, moved back down to the Canadian zone as Dumais goes back for it. 140 points for Dumais last year. Was not invited to the CHL Top Prospects game in his draft year. A lookout. Matejczuk puts skates there with Minton. And Dumais was also cut by Team Canada at the World Junior Camp last year, so had a bit of a chip on his shoulder all year and put up 140 points. In comes Geeky. Winds in. That's poke checked away by Pieniniemi. And back at the point, Matejczuk couldn't reach that. As time winds down here in the period, Dumais quickly ahead for Celebrini. Backlund Celebrini with time winding down, moves in. Oh. Celebrini plays it back across. The pass was blocked Oh, that was close as well, right at the horn.
He just pulled that through his legs. That late chance on a power play that didn't click too much.
Danielson, the lone goal in the opening period. It's day one of the 2024 World Junior Hockey Championship. Canada's got a 1-0 lead after one. Coming up, our first intermission with James Duffy in the panel.
The 2024 IIHF World Junior Hockey Championship is brought to you by the Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup.
Your first intermission here on TSN. Everybody wants to be the guy who scores the first goal for Canada. Someday Nate Danielson will say he sniped at top shelf, but it's whatever. Off his rear end, he has his first, and he's with Kenzie.
Well, it does feel like another ordinary day here at the World Juniors, Nate. For Team Canada to open the scoring for yourself personally, that was your first time playing a period of World Junior Hockey. Can you describe what that moment was to score the goal?
Yeah, obviously it was pretty special to score the first one here in front of all the Canada fans. It felt good.
You talk about the Canada fans here. It's pretty special when you go up the ramp and go to your bench, you just see a sea of Canada fans. Does that give you some confidence seeing some familiar faces in the stands?
Yeah, I think it gave us a lot of energy. I mean, we have the best fans in the world, and I mean, they all came over here and supported us, so it definitely gave us a boost of energy and helped us out that period.
Look at your line with Beck, Allard. You guys have been consistent since exhibition play. What is it about your group that allows you to be that shutdown line here for Canada?
Yeah, I think we just have a lot of speed on our line. We all compete really hard and kind of just want to get energy for the guys, and had a good shift there and got a goal, so I think just got to keep doing that.
Thanks. Best of luck.
Yeah, thank you.
And we'll get to that goal in a second with Cheryl Pounder, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie. But so much pressure, so many questions on goaltending, as there always is for Canada coming in, and you have an undrafted guy who's starting. An easy way to win over a nation really fast is to make what could end up being the save of the tournament in the first period you've played in the tournament.
Well, I mean, whether you're a goaltender or whether you're a fan at home, you're probably thinking, most important thing, starting the tournament, get through that first 20 minutes unscathed. Don't give up a bad goal. Don't do anything to deflate your team or take away any momentum. Well, then you go out and make what might be one of the saves of the tournament by the time it's all said and done. Certainly a candidate. And Team Canada's defense, they kind of blow a tire at the blue line. They get outnumbered, and it's wide open. And what a tremendous read by Russo to come over. And the thing that was really impressive with that is he was sliding backwards into the net. It would have been real easy for that glove to slide back over the line, but he was able to push himself back out, keep the glove and the puck on the right side of the line.
And I talked about the coach having trust in players and wanting to go to a line after that to create some momentum, and he goes to the identity line, the Beck line, and they ultimately score the most Canadian goal ever, and that's what the coach loves to see. These guys get out there, they get on the forecheck, they work it down low. Beck, Danielson, and O'Dog down low were fantastic. Matejchuk has some patience at the point, gets it to Lamoureux and Danielson just in front of the net, and it goes off his rear end. That's what the coach wants to see, and this identity line is going to be counted on in this tournament. Goals for, goals against, that's the line he's going to throw on the ice to change it, turn the tide of the game.
And by the way, that Owen Allard, who O is calling O'Dog, that's the hardest working O'Dog I've ever seen.
Yeah. He's the best O'Dog to ever play in this tournament.
You get the nickname, you're the hardworking guy in the team. It's kind of a thing.
That's where he came from, right?
That's right.
39 seconds elapsed, by the way, between that save and the goal, which we see so often in hockey, the definition of an early turning point.
Well, yeah, and it's all about using the big ice to your advantage, and you're going to see a lot of point shots because as the puck goes low, if it works its way high, you certainly are going to get a lot off, as Lamoureux did on that goal. But also, you have to drive outside the dot. So look at this. Patra is going to drive outside the dot. So he's wide. That automatically draws the defender. Now he draws low. So you got to pull everyone outside of the middle. That's exactly what happens. And then getting into that lost pocket is Savoy. Again, down below the goal line. Now you're working on the wall. Once you're working on the wall, you've drawn two. Now you can work a cycle. Look at the middle of the ice that is exposed. Again, a shot coming off there. And of course, you can see Warren up top as everyone's collapsed now towards a puck. This is going to happen on big ice. And guess what? Now you're in a situation where you can use the point. So it's all about using the width, using the depth of the ice, and knowing how to manipulate it to get your opportunities.
Off the rush, there's not available a lot available for Canada off the rush, and they have to tighten up a little bit defensively. Finland got a lot of opportunities in. Bobby showed that save. They just have to tighten up, and there's nothing there. They've got to get it in and work the forecheck.
The tournament's been in North America for a while. It's been a while since we've seen the big ice. You, when you played, liked it, right?
Yeah, I liked it because I was a skater, and you have to be be a transition skater to be able to turn and go with the play. So if I was going to chase outside the dots, I knew I could get back within.
By far the most noticeable duo on the ice for Canada was Savoy and Poitras.
Poitras, I talked about the NHL experience, and everybody was jittery at the start of the period, and you're looking for a guy to make some plays out there. And every time he had the puck on his stick, he was comfortable and making plays. You saw the loss of pucks and scrambly play. Every time he was out there, this guy was a difference maker. The play to the slot right here, and that's what you're looking for when you bring this guy over from the Boston Bruins, a guy to be calm and lead the charge in the first period, because it was scrambly to start the period, and he was definitely Canada's best player. Savoy as well, he's got those chances, and I just feel if he gets in tight again, he's going to create an opportunity and score a goal for Canada here.
I think what we learned, pretty good period for Canada all in all. It didn't seem like there were a lot of jitters out there, but we also learned that
it was a steady build to it.
And the Finns are going to be tough, and it's going to be a tight game.
The Finnish goaltender Coco was really good in that period.
Excellent. We have more ahead for you here in intermission. Mission number one, including a check-in on the other game that happened earlier on today. Slovakia expected to be perhaps a challenger at this tournament with a great opening day performance against Czechia.
Summary, Nate Danielson gets his first of the tournament, deflecting on the point shot by Maverick Lamoureux, who was initially not awarded an assist, but Mike Johnson expresses outrage, and as a result, does get a point. And Connor Geeky played 8.5 minutes in the first period for Canada. One thing we've seen in the pre-tournament and the first period of this game, Mike, is that we will see Canada put on a lot of pressure.
They talk about relentless, they talk about their identity, how they want to play when they play well. And that means getting pucks in deep, being physical, turning pucks over, playing smart, and really making plays in the offensive zone along the wall. And right from the beginning of the game, Gord, they established how they wanted to put the puck in deep, winning puck battles, nice and close puck support, sealing walls when available, and then the rest of the game came from there. Turnovers because of the back pressure, leading to chances going the other way. I think the coaching staff, for the most part, would look at that first period and say, guys, that's kind of what we want to look like. And when we do it like that, we get our chances, we get our opportunities, and trust that we will eventually get some past Coco, who was very strong in the first period.
Canada has 39 seconds of power play time to carry into the second period. Later tonight here, it'll be Sweden taking on Latvia. And at Flundeborg, the other arena, it'll be the United States and Norway. Poitras goes after it, and a puck just by him. And Dennis Bayak is calling the games at Flundeborg. His career began 50 years ago in Flin Flon, Manitoba. He retired as the voice of the Jets last year, and this tournament will be his last. As a play-by-play announcer, congratulations, Dennis, and we're looking forward to listening to you the rest of the way here. What a run.
He's been great for a long time and a great teammate to work with.
Owen Allard moves that in. And now at the line, it's held. Chance for Matthew Wood on a steal by Savoy. Now the Finns break in 4-on-1. And walking right in, and hits. Hammered there by Nucker right out of the penalty box. And Rousseau appeared to get a piece of that. Another chance, that deflects wide. This time off the stick of Koskiperti.
Need some awareness here, only one defenseman on the ice for Canada.
Fagnomi walks in and shoots, a shut down short side by Rousseau. They'll play back in front, great chance in tight again for Hamanaho, who's been all over it so far this afternoon, but a highlight reel save in the first period and a point blank stop there by Rousseau. Hamanaho slides that back down. Kalenius stands on a pass in front, knocked away by Bond. And waiting for is Carson Rakoff. 31 goals in 31 games for Kitchener of the Ontario League. 13th forward for Canada to start this tournament. Otto Salin with it. Snaps that rink wide. The puck was in the feet of Jiří Lassila. Otto Salin back through the middle. Chipped ahead by Koskimäki, but picked up by Matejczyk, who chips it back for Bond. And back at the line. Puck skipped away from Pieniemi. Back, trying to leave it there for Danielson. And all brought back the other way, and Pieniemi is taken down. The Finns hollering for a penalty, but play continues. Danielson. Up ahead for Rakoff. That pass bounced away. And here is Salin back with it. An LA fifth round pick. That's looked at high in the air and back out. 13 of these Finns are drafted. And here is Connor Geeky with it. Lead pass and just sneaking in there was Dumais.
Geeky knocked down that clearing attempt. The Finnish player halted and broke his stick on the play. Lamoureux slides it back across to Furlong with a shot that's steered away by Coco. Now behind the goal, Minton. For Dumé, he got tied up there by Salen. Furlong steps up, chipped by him. And Furlong held off Kupalainen. Here's Minton back with it. Busting in with Dumé. Dumé centers it, Minton tipped that just wide. Geeky steps up once again. Knocks down a clearing attempt, but it skips by Furlong and back down the ice. Back to pick it up, Everett Lamoureux. Out for Wood. And now Furlong goes back along with Lamoureux. Furlong pivots. Throws up the center. Knocked down by Jaeger for Geeky. Matthew Wood gloves that down. Wood chips it behind the finish goal. Gathered up there by Keskinen. Leaves it back for Kaki. And that pass just missed Keskinen. Ty Nelson chips it back around for Celebrini. Nelson back with it. For Bonk. His dad was an Olympic gold medalist for the Czechs back in the 1998 Olympics. And now a staunch Canadian fan. Saw his son win a gold medal at the Hlinka Gretzky tournament. The under 18 summer event that's held every year. Celebrini hustling after it. That's taken away by Juna Väisänen. Bonk. High in the air to center ice, gloved down by Karki. Karki drops it back and winding in. That shot was blocked. Hemming got it away, but Nelson got in the way. Bonka tied up in the corner. Celebrini comes back to help out. Jaeger trying to knock that free, but it's held at the line for the moment by Koskipirti. That pass goes off a skate. Racing to it is Wood. Quick shot there. But Pulkkinen was turned away. Celebrini chips it back down. Pulkkinen plays it back to center ice. Held by Celebrini for the moment. And Jaeger looks ahead. Laid back in by Cowan.
Amazing how clean Canada was in the first period. Not so much Finland forcing some mistakes and then on the breakouts, turning pucks over and getting their chances and now drawing a penalty.
That's going to be Cowan who goes off. And finally touched up by Savoy. And the Finns will get their second power play of the game with 3:16 gone here, or 4:16 rather, gone in the period.
27 minor penalty tripping.
Easton Cowan loses body position from being broken in and a can opener. And we got a lot of different names for that maneuver.
Yeah, the can did open.
And Finland will go to the power play. Looking to continue to build on. It's been a positive start to the second period. So Alan Letang looks down his bench.
Finns had no shots in their first power play. It was early in the first period.
They look a little disjointed, almost too early in the game. Had some nerves in the first power play for Finland.
Beck wins that faceoff back to Lamoureux. Plays it off the glass, but not out. Shorter end glass here in this rink than these players would be used to in North America. Kulanumi slides that back to Keskinen. We have a Keskinen. Feeds it back in front, and that just missed the stick of Jari Lassila. Race for it. Beck hustling in. Beck scored a shorthanded goal in the pre-tournament for Canada. Canada played three pre-tournament games. Once again, one against a Danish under 25 team, then the Swiss and the United States. Lead pass. Busting in there was Haltonen. Rolled off his stick. Back across the top. Haltonen takes that pass. Moves it back to Kulanomi. Keskinen. Kulanomi. And that shot goes off a skate onto the stick of Keskinen. He couldn't corral the puck.
Russo Keskinen blew a tire coming across there.
Played back across. That's hammered wide.
Did
by
again.
Haltonen. Haltonen has it bounce off his stick and back to center ice. And Russo is checking his skate.
Twice there, he lost his balance on a side-to-side move.
Kulanomi. Drops that back, and it's brought in by Lassila. Lassila, back for Kulanomi. Helenius Alanias takes the return pass from Keskinen. Going to me. Feeds it back across to Hultinen. Goes back to Alanias. And Alanias winds in.
He's looking for the seam the whole time. He's trying to go all the way through.
Villanumi. Back for Hellenius. To the goal mouth he goes, and that hard pass by Keskinen goes all the way down the ice. Canada changing, quick up for the Finns. Hellenius moves in, but the play's offside at the Canadian line, and Rousseau is having a look at that skate.
Cleaning the ice off because something was amiss. A couple different sequences. Hey, he's moving around a lot. You see him twice. He tried to dig his skate in the ice, and he missed it. The blade just didn't bite. He's flying right outside the post because his blade won't bite. Then the next time through, he's working. And yeah, that time it kind of worked a little bit late. So that is the uncomfortable feeling for a goaltender. You can't trust your edges.
5 seconds to go in Finland's power play. Geeky chops that ahead.
I don't think the goalies have the quick in and out plays like the players do now.
Some do, yeah. No shots to the Finns on that power play. Bow drops it back, and the long shot ticketed by Karki. Rebound loose in front. Savoy knocks that back for Warren. Noah Warren's pass for Savoy out of his reach. An icing call against Canada.
Man, I can remember Tuukka Rask a couple times lost his blades out of his. Henrik Lundqvist has.
And well, Tuukka Rask lost his mind because they wouldn't stop play.
Nor should they. So little click blades that they can slip in and out. He's still checking it. Clearly something amiss on the right inside edge. Matisse Rousseau. I mean, no more important piece of equipment than your skates. It's the foundation of everything you're doing.
Face off, not done fairly. Connor Geeky in for the draw against Hellenius, who was not sheltered at all by this Finnish team. Hellenius having a great year for Jukurit in the Finnish Elite League. 20 points in 28 games as a 17-year-old in that league.
That is so hard to get points in that league. Top players are nowhere near a point a game.
In comes Cowan. Drops it off to Savoy. Savoy goes rink wide. Geeky throws that wide of the goal. Picked up by Cowan. Looks down to Savoy. Now back at the point, Furlong. Lifts it back ahead for Cowan. Tried to slide that pass for Geeky. And jumping up is Warren. His pass picked off and brought up by Nokarinen. Nokarinen has Hamanaho with him. And Warren takes that pass. And a nifty backhand play for Savoy, who chips it for Celebrini. Back then Celebrini jumping in. Celebrini has a look. Canada changing. Celebrini gathers it back up. Plays that back, and the puck skipped away from Donovan. Celebrini. Trying to thread that pass ahead, it bounced back to him. Coco up to play it. And jumping up his bomb. Plays it back in the corner. Break off Simmons, and that's tipped wide by Celebrini. Donovan jumps up from his blue line spot, plays it down to Celebrini. That pass, though, intercepted by Lassila. Larry Lassila, the Finnish captain, moves it ahead to Kaskimäki jumping in. That's knocked away by Rousseau. Lassila drops it back, and that shot pounded wide by Hultinen. Kaskimäki was spilled. The Finns are hollering for a penalty. Here's Donovan. Drops it back to Rakov. Lassila has lost his stick on the play. Quickly gathers it back up. Picked up by Donovan. Slides that down to Bonk. Celebrini with it. Macklin Celebrini. Plays it ahead for Rakov. Canada changing as Bonk goes off. Donovan holds it. And Donovan plays it back in deep. He'll go off as well. Coco slides it back down to Pieniniemi. Up to center ice, and it's moved ahead by Hultinen. And racing back was Matejczuk to take that away. Lamoureux, lead pass out of the reach of Allard. And Lamoureux rather back for it. Matejczuk moves out ahead to Beck. Oh, nifty move by Owen Beck at center ice. In he goes for Allard. And Allard had it knocked away by Karki. Danielson, the Canadian goal scorer, slides that back. Matejczuk, long lead pass on the tape, and a hard shot there by Danielson, turned away by Coco. And a big hit by Allard as he stepped in the vice of it. Brought in by Keskinen. He's poked checked by Danielson. Away comes Beck. End of a long shift for him. He'll go off as it's laid offside, as indicated for Canada. Racing back is Furlong. Plays it back around to Matejczuk. Jake Furlong. Up ahead he goes for Cowan. Rink wide to Patra. Matt Patra works it and shoots. It's off a stick. Up and out of play. 1-0 Canada leads in the second period. Day one of the 2024 World Junior Hockey Championship.
Tony bet.
Whitman check at the break. Not surprisingly, we saw him stumble a couple times, checking his edge, seeing if it was okay, and he goes to the bench and they work on the right skate blade. They did not pop it in or out. He just wants to make sure it slides smooth, bites when he needs. And if you're gonna take care of the right one, might as well take care of the left one while you're at it. Keep that in mind.
Furlong, a long wrist shot, bounces back in front. Patra just missed that. And a big hit by Savoy as he slammed down his man. Took down Emil Hemming. Lead pass for Patra just missed. Still hard after it. And Savoy trying to knock that free. It's brought out by Kulunumi. And Nelson knocked that away. Cowan chipped that to Patra. Gathers up the pass again, but it's poked ahead and finally gathered up by Furlong. Out to center ice, he goes to Cowan. Easton Cowan winds in. Throws that rink wide for Nelson. Savoy has it back. Matt Savoy sends it back in front. That pass for Patra was labeled for the back of the net, but picked off by Bow. Patra was all alone at the side of the finish goal. Cowan sends it back ahead for Dume. Jordan Dume in, shoots at the goalpost. Bouncing puck, and it just skipped away from Patra. What a chance there for Dume. Cowan. That rink wide pass knocked down. Lamoureux goes back for Dume. Canada in the midst of a change here. And a careful play in front of the Canadian bench by Lamoureux. Matejczuk up for Minton, plays it in. And Dume goes after it. That centering pass. Picked off by Nokarinen. Amanaho works in for Helenius, who was tapping for it. The puck got down to Rousseau. He knocked that away. Here's Helenius back on it. Lamoureux ranges back. And Lamoureux being forced there by Helenius. Plays it back around to Matejczuk. Inside, eight to go here in the second period. Minton moves in, but the play's offside. At the finish blue line, a great look for Jordan Dume, but the Montreal native finds the iron here in Gothenburg.
My window's like a mirrored reflection. I have to steer you in the right direction.
Every trip, you can depend on Esso to be the place between places, connecting you to what's next.
Tranquila, levo a vida tranquila. Não tenho medo do mundo. Não tenho medo do mundo. Não vou me preocupar.
Canada looking to extend their one-goal advantage. George Dume jumps off the bench, gets lost in behind the Finnish defenders, and he's in alone. Gets the puck to get flat, just the right spot, underneath the glove, above the pad, perfect. But just a half inch too far outside to the right. Cleanly beats Coco, but not the post.
We have done hundreds, if not thousands, of games involving Finland at various levels internationally over the years.
They love.
How many times do you see this?
1-0, yes. I mean, just hanging right around. Bend but don't break. Make life tough.
Shorten the game.
And they've been better in the second period than the first. They would not like their period so far.
Matthew Wood digs that free. Looks for Celebrini. And Celebrini knocks it out.
Well, that's why if you're Canada, you think, yeah, let's get that second one. Like, let's try to stretch it out a little bit.
Here comes Bonk. Plays it back across. That's skipped away from Braden Jaeger. It's down to Wood. First player from the University of Connecticut ever to play for Canada at the World Junior. Celebrini trying to dig that free. Out at center ice, here's Bonk with it. Back for Celebrini. Canadian player tied up behind the play.
Their sticks are intertwined. What is happening right now?
Wood is tangled up there with the captain, Lasila. Now Danielson with it. Nate Danielson walks right in and shoots. Bouncing puck in front, just out of the reach. Better chance. And Danielson hammered that wide. And now behind the play again, we got Celebrini tied up, this time by Salen. Picked up by Danielson, trying to throw it back in front. He does. Allard scores. Owen Allard wasn't sure at first, but he's got one. And Canada's got a 2-0 lead.
It's another offensive sequence that starts with a line change.
It's all Allard jumps in prior to that, causes a disruption, missed opportunity, and then eventually gets the puck. I think he hits the post, then the back of the leg, and then the back of the net. And that time the post is kind to Canada as they get a break. A puck that wasn't going in. Karams off the heel of Coco. In behind the net, that's 2 points for Danielson. The same line has gotten both goals. The so-called checking line has provided both goals of offense for Canada.
And what a story Owen Allard is, the Ottawa native. Went to the Senators prospect camp in the summer of 2022, injured his shoulder, played just 14 games last year for Sault Ste. Marie. He's gone through two NHL drafts unpicked. He's been to a couple of NHL camps, but just a great story by a player who has had to deal with some significant adversity as a youngster. You've heard about, and Al Letang has talked about this, a number of these players are new to international hockey because there wasn't a lot of tournaments. And there's a trip now being called on Savoy. Is that shot hammered off the post by Newman? Newman comes winding in. Katecha couldn't reach it. Played back now to Kangas. Kali Kangas looks back down to Lasila. Extra skaters on the ice now for the Finns. Lasila plays it back across. Keskinen. Rickson shoots. Hammered that wide. Chance now for Newman. Throws it back in front. 6-on-5 here for the Finns. Waiting for the power play to come. Lasila plays it back across. Scooped up there by Kupalainen. Kupalainen lays it back. Hard shot by Newman. Kicked up by Rousseau. And Canada can't gain possession here. Keskinen. This is a minute of 6-on-5. Long shot, but just wide by Kolonimi. And finally touched up. And with 4:54 to go in the second period, the Finns will go on the power play after Canada made it a 2-0 lead.
Tony Bet,
get treated like a VIP. Bet on live games with odds on all sorts of sports. That's what you get when you bet with
Tony Bet.
It calls you to a place with no boundaries, where the trail ends and the beyond begins.
The Chevrolet Silverado ZR2. Built to take you where the trail ends, so you can go beyond.
For a limited time only, finance a Silverado at 0% on select 2023 models for up to 60 months. Offer ends January 2nd.
Take about 20% off of there, bud.
Finland heads to their third power play of the game as a quick turnover. Matt Savoy gets caught and Newman steps on his stick for the obvious trip. He goes down. And a power play that hasn't even registered a shot on goal yet in their first two attempts for Finland. Pretty important moment in the game to try to get back within one.
When the Finns are successful internationally, they rely heavily on their power play. That long shot deflected, and Rousseau makes a good stop on that. And Furlong giving the business to Hamanaho in front.
Hamanaho has been the most dangerous Finnish forward in the game so far. Right off the faceoff, flow to the net, stick on the ice. Newman puts it right there. Great look. And chop to the corner of the net. Probably finds the back of the net.
That's the Rousseau third good stop Rousseau has made on Hamanaho in this game.
Including a 2-on-0 backdoor break, which you never think you're going to miss.
Hamanaho is a second-round pick of New Jersey in the 2023 draft.
Worth noting, wide rink, low boards. It's hard to hard rim the puck for a defensive all the way out. It just doesn't get there. You have to have one pass before the clear often.
Brought up by Karki. Drops it back to Hellenius. Cross ice pass out of the reach of Newman. And back at the point. Kept alive by Karki. Hamanaho. Back for Newman. To Karki. Back in for Newman. Slides that down and takes a return pass from Kaskimaki. Karki. Long shot scores! That's deflected in front. Might have been Kaskimaki who got a piece. And the Finns have a power play goal to cut the lead to one.
Shooting for sticks. We just saw Newman try it. And a really good look from the blue line. As Kaskimaki doesn't stand below the goal line, slides to a dangerous position, and yeah, opens up the blade and cuts it right up over top. Karki head up the whole way. This is not really trying to score. He drops it onto the blade of Kaskimaki. Beautiful tip. No chance for Russo. And Finland right back within one.
Kaskimaki, a third round pick of St. Louis. The Blues have six prospects playing in this World Junior Championship, the most they've ever had here. Lots of fans from the country next door. They've not put the goal up now, they just have on the scoreboard. So yes, Finland down by one. And they'll no longer be dimming the lights after goals. We saw that the first period after the Canada goal. That's not gonna happen again. There by Matejcha. Geeky reaching for it. Matejcha bangs out ahead. Dumais on it. And now Matejcha drops it off as Minton tried to send it up. The pass was broken up by Keskinen. In comes Minton with a chance. Pokes it on goal. Coco makes the stop. And the rebound rolls wide. Here's Matejcha with it. Minton Matejcha shoots. And that hit Minton. He was thrown down in front. And Coco freezes that.
Canada trying to go back to work after Finland closed within one on the power play. And the patient look from Karki. The tricky part for Canada is they have sticks in the way, but he sauces one over or gravity drops it right down to Kaskimaki. And never fun when you're stepping out of the box, as Matt Savoy was.
Now Pontra for the faceoff, along with Savoy and Cowan. Brings that draw from Hellenius, and Cowan plays it back in. Patra has it taken away by Hinniemi. Now loose in front, a little backhand shot by Patra, and the save made by Nicholas Coco. I'll scan the QR promo code on screen to get 50% off Crave Basic and start streaming the best series and biggest hit movies all in one place on Crave.
Matt Patra has been very good in this game. Another chance off a turnover, get in the middle of the ice. Him and Savoy have had a great connection.
Gothenburg has turned into a good-sized Canadian town this week. Played back by Cowan to Bonk. Played back across. Patra has a look. Matt Patra. Oh, slides that back, and the pass misfired for Nelson. Patra being watched by Hellenius, trying to work that free. Here's Hellenius. Rink wide he goes. Picked off by Bonk. Canada quickly back the other way. Cowan. Easton Cowan works in. Drops that back. Long shot. And Nelson turned away by Coco.
Some of that is communication. Ty Nelson just arrived yesterday, has not practiced with the group over in Europe. So Patra is walking along the blue line. He's not sure, is Nelson going to look for a pass? Is he sliding for open ice? And those kind of chemistry issues are something you got to work through when your first time on the ice over in Europe is a game against Finland.
Nelson, the first overall pick in the 2020 OHL draft. 2.5 to go here in the second period. Slovakia open with an impressive win against Czechia. And Celebrini had that bounce. Wait, takes it right back. Celebrini trying to drop that back, and the pass is picked off by Lassie. Lassila skates it back out. Lassila chips that back down to the Canadian zone. Goes after his own shoot-in as Furlong shields him off the puck. Added up by Jaeger. Braden Jaeger was tied up along the board. And Warren plays it back around to Furlong. Jake Furlong has that go off his stick. And now tip to the center. Knocked down by Rakoff. Carson Rakoff works in. Walks right in. Shoots. That goes wide.
Rakoff getting a more consistent shift in the second period. Starting the game as the 13th forward.
Matejczyk knocked that down for Rakoff. Works it again. Fans on the shot. Leaves it back. Celebrini with a chance. And Coco got a piece of that. And bench hollering for a change here. Celebrini loose behind the finish goal. I wonder if he thought about it there.
I did.
Celebrini fed back in front. That missed Rakoff. And now this line will change. Matejczyk holds. Goes rink wide for Celebrini. Drops it down to Danielson with a shot. Coco the stop. And Danielson, who opened the scoring, plays that back for Lamoureux. A long shot into the glove of Nicholas Coco. He'll hang on to that. I thought maybe that they might see a Michigan.
Yeah. He's back there by himself. We saw Bedard and Zegras, two former World Junior stars, pull it off just this past week. And a really good save by Coco. Just the top bit of the pad on the broken play. Celebrini gets down to get a good look. Celebrini is opportunistic like that. Just darts in open ice and makes good things happen when he gets there.
Off the draw, here's Lamoureux with it. Played back in the high slot. Danielson a hard shot. Coco the save on that. Allard, who has the second Canadian goal, moves up. And now the final minute of the second period. Danielson slides that back to Lamoureux. Up he goes for Beck. The puck was in his feet. And Beck moves it ahead. Along with Danielson and Allard. Oh, pass. Great pass back. Matejczyk walks right in, plays it back across, and Danielson couldn't get the shot away as Newman got a stick on him. And throwing it around in the final minute of the second period. Matejczyk in deep. Feeds it back across to Danielson. Danielson centers it Allard with a chance. Coco to stop. He's seen enough of this. He'll hang on, and now Newman's got a hold of Beck.
That's Beck smart. Keep your hands down, your mouth open. And see if you can't draw a penalty. And what an opportunity here. This rush by Beck. Excellent lateral play by Matejczyk. And this is the 23-point streaker. Drag, and he's looking at Danielson, who I don't even think was ready for that, as Newman desperately gets a stick on it. But Matejczyk has that no fear, that offensive defenseman roll with. He doesn't think about what bad might happen if I don't pull this off. He just goes out there and pulls it off.
35 points in 24 games with Moose Jaw of the Western League this year. We mentioned his 23-game point streak was snapped in the game before he left for the Canadian camp.
Didn't want the pressure of keeping that going here for Canada. Start fresh. He's 1-for-1 in the tournament.
Geeky kicking at it. 15 seconds to go in the second period. Now picked up by Minton. Fraser Minton. Bonk had moved up. He was calling for it. Time winding down here in the period. Pulkkinen. Move that back. Some more pushing and shoving breaks out as Kulanumi's got his gloves up. But Canada goes to the dressing room with a 2-1 lead. After two periods of play, Owen Allard has his first. It's day one of the 2024 World Junior Hockey Championship. From Gothenburg, Sweden, our second emission is coming up.
The 2024 IIHF World Junior Hockey Championship is brought to you by the Chevrolet Good Deeds Cup. Do good, fill the cup, and your team could win $100,000 for charity. Learn more at ChevroletGoodDeedsCup.ca.
James Duffy back with Cheryl Pounder, Jeff O'Neill, and Bob McKenzie. We see it every year. I mean, some years Finland's a gold medal contender. They've won three in the last 10 years. But even when they're not on paper, which was this year, they always give you a good game. How do they dominate the first half of that second period?
They love to scratch and claw, James, and come back in the game. And hockey players love to make the coach scratch their head because there was a steady build in the first period, and the coach must be thinking, okay, they've got it. Now they're ready to rock. And the start of the second period, it was not a good one for Team Canada. The dreaded 4-on-1 to start the period is never a good sign. And you talk about the coach scratching their head. You just can't have this to start the period. 4-on-1. Luckily, that opportunity misses the net. And just getting beat to pucks, dominated on the cycle, beat right there. People standing around. The Finns took it to Canada the first 5 minutes of that period. That's an unbelievable save right there to keep it out of the net. But once again, this is the stuff that Canada was doing in the first period. Win pucks off the cycle, get turnovers. That play can't happen. And the Finns turned it on and had great chances around the net, and the goaltender saved him in that first part of the period.
All of which made the Owen Allard goal even bigger for Canada. And if the cheer sounded a little larger than usual, it's because he might have the biggest contingent over here. His dad is the oldest of 13 kids. There are aunts and uncles and cousins and you name it over in Sweden for this tournament.
Yeah, big Ottawa Valley crew from Renfrew, and Sue Greyhound forward Owen Allard is a guy that when he was named to the team, some eyebrows were raised because he's not got the pedigree of being a first-round pick or even being drafted because of the injury that he suffered last year in his draft year. But he's also got the ability to get in on the forecheck, be physical, go to the front of the net, stick on the ice, boom, put it in. His dad, Sean Allard, his skills coach, does some skills work with the Colorado Avalanche. Now, Allard was brought along primarily to be that physical forecheck presence, to be a guy that would be a top penalty killer. But he's already worked his way onto the second power play unit, playing the net front. They want to get some energy from him in terms of the crash and bang effect in front of the net. And on that play, 5-on-5, did a great job on the forecheck, great job getting to the front of the net, and great job getting a goal.
Part of that identity line, as you're talking about, a line that can certainly change momentum in a game. And just in the paint, I just like his nose for the net, his knack, his physicality, the way he hounds and hunts below the goal line. I'm expecting him to get on the board again in this tournament, maybe even multiple times.
Allard, his last game before he came to camp, talk about coming in hot. His Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds were trailing Kingston in the third period. He had 3 points in the third to win the game, 5 points overall, and comes to the World Juniors and has a goal.
Maker.
Well, I tell you, it's historic because it's the first time in 29 years that an O-Dog has scored at the World Juniors. We got to go back to the original O-Dog.
Look at this. Driving the
Russia.
Net. Drive the net. Drive the net. Holding. Look at that.
Oh, that's that intensity hounding pucks, oh.
Yeah, that's just difference makers. O-Dogs are difference makers, Jimmy.
Do you think the current O-Dog is even aware of the O-Dog legacy that he is having
know.
Here?
I don't.
The PK was okay until trouble.
I'm not going to tell defensemen how to do their job on the PK because it's very difficult out there, but I do know one thing. If you stand in front of the net and just look at the point shot come in and you don't front the guy in front of the net, you're going to have some problems. You look right here, the box was good, all penalty kill for the Canadians, but right there, two of the Canada defenders are looking at this shot, and when you leave that guy out in front untouched, he's going to get his stick on him. He puts it in the back of the net.
Arttu Karkki, the Finnish defenseman with the shot from the blue line, also plays for the Greyhounds, mm-hmm. and a teammate of Allard's. He's got 16 goals, I think, on the year, and almost all of them on the power play. He's usually a shooter on that dot, but now he's running it from up top.
All right, opening game, tight game, 2-1, heading to the third. What do you want to see more from Canada in that last 20?
Open it up. Open up the neutral zone so that you can learn and play off the rush. And I think that's something they did better as the game has gone on. They found the space, and it's all about quick transition. They can move the puck, get going north right away. And that's Danielson again. I mean, he recognized the puck was on one side of the ice. He gets going, draws everyone back, and he gains entry. Again, quick transition. Take the middle of the ice. Force everyone to start pushing back, and then all of a sudden you've opened up the white paint. Now all of a sudden you can take it in, but it's got to be about quick transitions. It's got to be taking off along the flank so that you can push the defenders back.
Danielson's established himself in this hockey game. Every time he's on the ice, he's making plays around the goal and making things happen out there. He's been very good.
Our friends at SportLogic are monitoring all the key stats from this hockey game beyond the typical shots that we show you all the time. And the difference in this one, slot shots, it was 8-1 in the first, now 15-4 for Canada. So a big advantage there. And you were talking about the rush chances, Cheryl.
Yeah, and just look at that right now. I mean, 8 rush chances, and that's something that's huge. That's got, they're going to have more of that as they progress through this tournament. Learn how to use the ice.
It's a 2-1 lead for Canada after 4 minutes of play. For the second straight tournament, Canada's number one goaltender has gone unpicked through 2 NHL drafts. Last year was Thomas Millis. This year, it's Matisse Rousseau.
Yeah, and Rousseau, who's declared the number one goaltender right from the second they stepped into Europe, was a little bit shaky in the first couple of pre-tournament games, but has been rock solid in this game against Finland. Wasn't terribly busy in the first period, but made this incredible save on Hemenaho on a 2-on-0, and a little bit adventurous there with some skate issues in the second period and trying to kill off a penalty. He got that checked out on a break and went back in there, and the only one that's gotten by him in today's game was a unstoppable tip on a power play. So I would expect Rousseau to have to be pretty busy in the third period. Key will be for Canada, play this third period 5-on-5. Don't give Finland power play opportunities. At 5-on-5, Finland hasn't had many good looks.
And they'll start this third period 5-on-5. Both these teams will play tomorrow. Canada will take on Latvia. The Finns will play Germany. Powerful drop. Penalty coming to Canada. So much for that.
So much for that. Fraser. Oh, boy. That's going to go in. Got to go in.
Towards the empty. Oh, my goodness. Almost found a way to the empty net. As Pulkkinen to hustle back. Saw that years ago in an NHL game, Yuri Hudler dropped one back and it wound up at his own net playing for Dallas.
So play 5-on-5 lasted 3 seconds. As Fraser Minton gets an interference. Right off the faceoff.
The linesman was taking Geeky to the box.
I think it's Minton right here. He's trying to fight. Does he kick? If he kicks, that's a trip. As Hemenaho and him are fighting for position. And this one would have been a goal. As it just clips the side of the net. And I don't think Pulkkinen was going to catch it. I don't think he knew it was going to hit the side of the net. I just don't think he was going to get there. So huge kill for Canada to start the third period.
Finns are 1-for-3. Helenius steps in for the face-off against Owen Beck. And Beck wins that cleanly back. Matejczuk got spun around by Hamanaho, who's had all kinds of chances in this game. Karki plays it back around. Helenius trying to draw a hooking call there from Beck. Helenius back for Karki. Works it back across to Hunyas. Yes, the pass too far for him. Matejczuk steps up, chops at that. Lamoureux up along the boards, picked up by Newman. Newman feeds that down to Kaskimaki. Back for Newman. To Kaskimaki. Crisscrossing there with Hamenaho. Back for Newman. To the point he goes. Hard shot by Karki, rather turned away by Rousseau. And now Karki has to reach back for it.
You don't mind that shot with nobody in front. No screen.
Oh, that pass stolen by Beck, who fires it down the ice. Arctic Karki, Vegas third round pick, plays for Sault Ste. Marie in the OHL. Up for Lassila. Drops that back for Emil Hemming. And across the line, they're offside, as the play is called, at the Canadian line.
Great job by Canada so far. Is see Rory Mikkola watching on, knowing this is a really good opportunity for his group to get back in the game.
He was the head coach of Karpat's under 20 team for 7 years. He's gone through that organization. An assistant coach last year for the Finns, who saw their tournament end with a bitter defeat to Sweden in the quarterfinals. They allowed a shorthanded goal with 1:05 to go in regulation in a 3-2 loss.
You're thinking, here we go to win the game, and you lose it while shorthanded for Sweden. Tough.
Lassila works it back across for Hultonen. That pass picked up by Furlong. Looks at the side of the goal. Furlong gathers it back up.
Can you find it clear?
Lassila steals it back. Lays that down to Hultonen. Hultonen back down to Lassila. Looks back to Keskinen. Now played back across. And a hard shot by Keskinen bounces away, scooped back up. And a chance now for Canada, shorthanded. Cowan comes in. Easton Cowan works in on Kulunumi. And Kulunumi gets spun around behind the goal. He's got it back up by Ove Keskinen. Two shots of the Finns on that power play as Minton steps back on and remains 2-1 Canada. Up next today, the U.S. takes on Norway at 5:30 local time. Lead pass to Patra. Looks ahead to Minton. In comes Minton with a shot. That's gloved by Nicholas Coco.
Fraser Minton happy to be out of the box. Pressure off as Canada kills off his penalty. Third is CC Fraser Minton, who's played for a few teams already this year. Some with Toronto and Saskatoon and Kamloops. And Vancouver. And named captain. And what a huge honor that is. To be the captain of this team for a guy who hasn't played a whole bunch for Canada in his life.
Second time that's happened this year. Campbell's named the captain after he got back to Toronto and traded him. But they got a boatload from Saskatoon for him. Minton just forced his way into the Leaf opening night roster with a great training camp. That's brought in by Salonetlikov's side. Now Savoy chops at that. Kept alive by Pieniniemi. Pieniniemi looks back down to Kupalainen. But to the point he goes, and that shot was blocked by Rakoff. Rakoff back with it to the line, but not quite out. Donovan steps carefully into Kupalainen. Back at the point, held by Salin again. And that shot deflects wide. Kupalainen throws it back in front. And they try a little jam play there, but Bow couldn't poke it home. Bow back on it. Canada having trouble clearing the puck here. Savoy on it. Up for Patra. Matt Patra, the Whippy Ontario native. Puts it across for Savoy. That's knocked away. Canada changing a chance now for the Finns to move it up the ice. Aminaho. Lost the puck to Furlong. And Geeky lifts it high in the air. Rink-wide pass finds Dume. Jordan Dume. Throws it rink wide. The pass just in behind Minton. The Finnish defender collided with his netminder. Back at the point. Furlong drops it off for Minton to Nelson. Ty Nelson has a look. Shoots. That's it. Coco rebound. Minton panned on that. The puck loose. And Coco pounces on that.
That puck moving so slowly and nobody could quite get to it. As Minton almost finding a loose opportunity. Ty Nelson, of course, looking to shoot it. Hits Tarkey's skate. Minton can't quite get enough on the rebound. As he's defended. Valenius, good job getting over top of the stick of Minton.
Lassila wins the faceoff. Played back down to the Canadian zone. Lamoureux chops at that. Here's Geeky with it. Connor Geeky. Up ahead to Minton. And it's scooped up by Juha Väisänen. And now falling on the play was Kaskimaka. Kaskimaka can't draw a penalty that time. Matejczak knocked his man off the puck. And the poke goes over the glass and out. The Finns are suggesting it might have gone straight out, but the linesman said right away it was deflected.
Yeah, you're seeing the Finnish team every time someone goes down there looking to create a call, knowing how for the power play the refs are getting together to see who this one went off of last over the shorter glass. It is worth noting behind the net in the offensive zone, the glass is probably a few feet shorter. And so after the conversation, it's going to be off Finland.
The one linesman said it was deflected out.
You get a better look at it here. Oh, it's just shot straight out by a Finnish player.
I'm going to stick up at the end of that. Face off is won by Beck. And you can see his role coming into focus here for Team Canada. Takes important face-offs, plays against the other team's top line, and produces some offense.
The checking line has been good for both goals in this game.
And after the whistle, a little contact there. Kupalainen and Beck got tangled up.
Not much there. There hasn't been too much of this in this game. And obviously, both teams full of emotion, full of passion, but also understanding, got to be careful, got to be smart. And the whistle had gone twice, and a gentle bump from Kupalainen is always enough to get the reaction's like, come on, barely touched him. I recognize that look anywhere.
All right, now back for an offensive zone face-off against Keskinen. His uncle Esa, the second most points for Finland all time at the World Junior Championship. Facing back is Kulanumi. Plays it back down, a race for it now. Newman getting in there, but Lamoureux ranges back with that long reach and takes it away. And here's Beck with it. Beck, the Montreal draft pick, plays it back. Beck under the Montreal lineup last year on an emergency basis. He's called up from junior. Newman with it. Plays it back, and that's knocked away from Kupalainen.
Canada's got to keep working on getting pucks off the wall when they're trying to break out of their own end.
You'll see Pulkkinen. Works in, shoots, that's gloved easily by Rousseau, who'll hang on to that.
You see, Jesse Pulkkinen, who's had an incredible year to start with his under 20 team. 28 points, just 18 games.
He's also seen some time with JYP Jyväskylä in the Finnish top league, the SM Liiga.
And then he played up and doing pretty well there. His draft stock rising.
A lot of these Finnish players will play for multiple teams in the year. They'll play for the top division team. Is that shot deflected wide off the stick of Hemming? Also playing the U-20, and some of them are still playing in the U-18 league. Noah Warren steps up. Slides at Rakoff. Great pass ahead. Celebrini with a shot at the post. And that skips over the glass and out. What a look there for Macklin Celebrini. 13:56 to go in the third period. Canada, a 2-1 lead on Finland on day one of the World Junior.
It's a woman's job to give a man perspective.
Dipped. Drizzled. Sandwiched. Sprinkled or straight up. There's a million ways to enjoy Cavendish Farms fries, but only one way to make them the right way. Grown, picked, washed, chopped, checked, and packed up just right. Cavendish Farms, made our way, enjoyed your way.
We are playing to win.
I'm coming for you.
Macklin Celebrini has that gift of popping into space, hasn't done too much, and creating something great out of it. The first touch, and you see that wrist right by the ear of Coco. Beats him clean, but rings it off the bar. So what he does, just pops up and creates.
And then I'll play that ahead. Warren swings back to pick it up. Oh, Warren playing for Victoriaville in the Quebec League after 3 years in Gatineau. And here comes Celebrini again. Celebrini turns it back in front. That's knocked out by Coco with Rakoff steaming in. Carson Rakoff getting more of a regular shift here in the second and third period. Fired back down as Karki goes back. Celebrini shadowing him, and it's picked off. Got it back up. Jaeger centers it. Loose puck in front. Celebrini with a chance. And Coco down. Able to make the stop. The referee takes a long look to see where the puck is.
The guys on the ice weren't sure that puck was. Almost Celebrini was checking to see that one slide under somehow. It did not.
It's at the top of the crease, but.
Good play by Rakoff to keep it alive. And there it is. And when Kangas goes in there behind. That's what you're wondering. This whole play, though, the rush by Celebrini starts with Noel Warren skating below his own goal line. He moves his feet, he foils the forecheck, and all of a sudden you get this going the other way because of it. And Canada wants to just take our time here and see where this puck ended up.
Right. I think they're going to have a look at
now. Was that puck under the pad, and Kangas put his stick on Kako's pad to push it out, or Coco's pad to push it out? They're celebrating over in Canada's bench. The guys are high-fiving as though it was a goal.
The play at the net is under review.
So you know what happened there. The Canadian video coaches called down.
And said, everybody, pull. Well, they know. This is not we hope. This is we know. Now we have, it was called no goal. So we'll have to see it over the line. Celebrini pokes it. And it's got to be...
There it is. There. You can see the puck pop out for a second.
As Kangas pushes Coco's foot under the line.
Here comes the puck.
There's
now.
The rebound attempt. Oh, it's inside his pad. It's inside his right knee. There it is. You could see it tuck in under the right knee pad of the goalie pad. Now you got to be able to see it over the goal line, though. And it's dragged out. No, it's on the initial. You won't be able to find it there, because Coco knows what he's doing. He's gonna keep his leg straight and hide the puck. Celebrini hopes he sees what he thinks he sees.
Yeah, I
saw it the first time through. Yeah. The first overhead, the puck goes across. And it gets frozen underneath the pad, right by the knee, and Team Canada fans are calling for a replay. So I am very comfortable that this puck was in. I am less comfortable that I can show you video
right.
that conclusively...
Because you've got to go to the finish bench and tell them.
Here it is. This is why we overruled and called it a goal.
Right. So the referees, Tobias Bjork on the right, Daniel Eriksson on the left, are going over it.
Here's the one I see it go across. Watch as the right knee, and it drags across, and there it is.
Yes.
And it's in right there.
Yeah, you can just
it's
see
very
it.
Hard to see, and it's by that white, just inside the white pad, but it's in. That's the view that it is clearly in. Looks like it was rolling as it went in there, but you could see distance between the puck and the goal line, and I think they saw the review I saw, and this one should be a goal for Canada. And for Celebrini.
We'll get to celebrate, belatedly. And the Canadian fans chanting goal. Look at this crowd of Canadians here. And here's Eriksson with the call.
After reviewing the play, it was determined that the puck completely crossed the goal line. We got a goal!
He's got some Wes McCauley in
it. Yeah, a little flair for the dramatic. And so Celebrini, the 17-year-old, has his first World Junior goal. What a moment for him, and what a moment for Canada to make it 3-1.
It's a huge goal. It's a huge goal in the context of this game, this group, for Celebrini. And it's what he does. He just produces. He hasn't been dominant in this game, but yet he's rang a crossbar. He's got a goal. And I think when Lauri Mikkola sees the replay, they'll know that that was the correct call.
So a 3-1 lead now with 13:22 to go in the third period. And Macklin Celebrini, whose dad Rick is the director of sport performance for the Golden State Warriors, and all the ties, you know, Celebrini goes to BU. San Jose GM Mike Greer went to BU. He spent a lot of time in the Bay Area. There's all this talk about Celebrini potentially winding up in the Bay Area, but right now his focus is on Gothenburg. And from day one of camp, Al Letang, the Canadian coach, has said, you don't get one player with him, you get three, because the two guys who play with him are always productive as well.
There's no doubt it's not him working into the lineup. He has got his spot secured in a prominent role, deservedly, in this lineup.
Yeah, he's not being sheltered. Macklin Celebrini announces his arrival at the World Junior Championship. It gives Canada a 2-goal lead. Now the Finnish player's helmet came off. He's got to get off the ice straight away. It came off Lassila. The lead pass finds Geeky. In with Dumais. Geeky for Dumais. What a pass. Back in front. Geeky with a chance. And Coco made the stop on that. Dumais plays it back across as Donovan steps up. Dorian Donovan walks right out. Donovan plays it right back in front. And knocked away by Kaskimaki. Alexandre Kaskimaki holds. Plays it back across. And a hard drive there by Newman. Kicked out by Rousseau. Patra moved that ahead. The Finnish player Newman was spilled. And here's Karki with it. Out to center ice. He finds Manisto. Newman played it back in front. And Manisto couldn't quite reach that. Karki back with it. Karki In for Newman, shoots, and Rousseau fights that off. Batra chips it back to center ice. Gathered up by Cowan. Easton. Cowan comes in with a shot, and that's knocked away by Väisänen. Got a stick on that. Cowan steals it right back. And Cowan plays that just wide of the goal. Cowan relentlessly hunting pucks for Canada now, along with Patra. Back at the point, Lamoureux. In for Cowan.
The battle, Patra and Väisänen going at it.
Corner to corner. And Cowan coming in to help out. Knocks down that clearing attempt for a moment. Poke back ahead, but the puck finally squirts across the line. And making a change as Savoy comes in. Matt Savoy, nifty play, moves ahead for Matichuk, and Matichuk gets the shot away that Coco knocks away. Allard. Back for Warren. Finds Beck. Owen Beck. Into Port Hope, Ontario. Lays that back and skips away. Moved ahead. In comes Allard, who chips it down. And stolen again by Beck. Stepping up, and Danielson had a retreat back to center ice. Moved out by Furlong. And in comes Danielson. Nate Danielson, oh, what a move, walks right in, and the play is knocked away by Pulkkinen. And Danielson sends it right back in. Beck in for Warren. He finds Allard looking down to Danielson. And the Finns bottle up here, finally play it down. The rolling puck got by Furlong. And icing waved off. Lassila's helmet still down there. As Danielson gathers up the loose puck.
For long enough, you gotta get another helmet on the bench for him.
Right. And Ahonius moves in and shoots. That's deflected wide. Pulkkinen steps up. Got knocked down there by Danielson. Celebrini almost off to the races there. Villanumi up for Pulkkinen. And moved in by Hamanahu. We'll think about all the great chances he's had in this game. Celebrini with a head of steam, had that poked away. And the play scrambled to the line. It's onside. Celebrini moves in. Picked up now by Bonk, Oliver Bonk. Winds it back ahead. In comes Jaeger. Braden Jaeger winds in. Jaeger shoots, and Coco got a shoulder on that. And the puck goes up and out. To the delight of more than 3,500 Canadian fans here in Gothenburg, Macklin Celebrini is giving Canada a 3-1 lead.
You to a place with no boundaries, where the trail ends and the beyond begins. The Chevrolet Silverado ZR2, built to take you where the trail ends, so you can go beyond.
Every line has had their moments for Canada at different times in this game, and Connor Geeky's line almost got that insurance goal. And really nice passing play here between Geeky and Azume. Little give, little go, and right back, and an excellent save by Coco. Geeky does his work right around the crease.
And Geeky wins the faceoff there. It's centered, and Dumais put that wide. Dumais in the goalpost in the second period. Played back around to Geeky. He slides it back to Nelson with a shot that's off a stick, high off the glass and out. And Ty Nelson doesn't need more than once asking to get a shot away. He had 10 shots on goal in his first OHL game this year.
That's hard to do. No matter how good your shot is.
Hard to do as a forward.
Yeah, and you don't even touch the puck that often in the offensive zone. Power play must run through him with a whole bunch of shooting attempts. And he's hanging in there pretty well in a tough game.
Just got here yesterday. Toronto native.
Said he slept extensively last night.
Yes, he would have.
Which we can relate to.
Off the draw, controlled by Canada. Dumais taps that back to Nelson. Dumais down for Minton. Couldn't pull that home. Now at the line, Nelson has to retreat. And that pass goes into the Finnish bench with 8:43 to go in the third period.
And Canada deserves credit because after that third goal, they've still done a nice job playing in the offensive zone. Not being risky, but getting in on the forecheck, making smart plays, chewing up clock like a field possession position game, staying down in the offensive zone as much as they can, limiting Finland's opportunities in their own end.
We're in the home of the Frölunda Swedish Hockey League team in this venerable arena, which has seen so many great players. And Alfredsson played here, of course, the Lundqvist twins. And you have to say the twins because Joel Lundqvist is a mythical figure here. Longtime captain of Frölunda. And that goes into the Canadian bench.
And the year I played in the 0-4 stoppage, we lost to Frölunda in the final with Henrik and Joel and Alfie. And in this rink, they were a wagon.
And the Trey Kroner fans are in evidence now as they'll see Sweden take on Latvia. High hopes for the Swedish team this year.
Canada in a bit of an unusual situation where they're maybe not a favorite or co-favorite. Well, the pundits picking the U.S. and Sweden as maybe the two best teams, with Canada and Finland in the tier below them. This is a big game, though, because...
There's a steal by Keskinen. Keskinen for Newman with a shot. And that knocked Matejczuk sticker out of his hand. Newman back with it. Lamoureux stepped into him. And Matejczuk taps it back to Lamoureux. Has some time, threads that pass ahead, but it's stolen by Kupalainen. Kupalainen. That butters back in front. Newman takes a swat at that. Keskinen now has it. Keskinen spins back. Kontra got a stick on him. And the puck squirts back to center ice, but some dangerous moments there after a turnover in the defensive zone for Canada. Kula Nummi plays it back across. Beck with a steal. Oh, and Beck spins back for Savoy. And now brought back the other way by Tommy Ministo, who plays at Michigan State. Ministo pivots back. And he's taken down. Penalty coming to Canada.
That's going to be Savoy again.
Yeah, doesn't like the call.
He's saying he's holding my stick. Well, I should not be getting a hook. He should be getting a hold. And that will fall on deaf ears. There's Ministo, you mentioned, hasn't played too much in this game. There's the hook into the arm, and then he... No, that's a hook every time.
Minor penalty for hooking.
That is not a chicken wing. That is a hook on Savoy. And... fourth power play for Finland.
Yeah, they're 1-for-4. Scored their only goal in the man advantage in the second period to cut the lead to 2-1. And back once again for the faceoff. Matejczuk. Plays it back around, but not out. Knocked down by Kula Nummi. Keskinen plays it across to Hemming. And Kula Nummi, national third-round pick, drops that back. Played back across, but getting a stick on that was Beck. Now stolen by Lamoureux, and he feeds it down the ice.
You can see how the defensemen are double-clutching on their clears. They're not sure where to send the puck because they know the long rim won't get it done. Glass also has the dashers on it, the stanchion, so it slows down any rings up in the glass as well.
Keskinen up ahead to Lassila. That goes Furlong, boarding a tangled up behind the goal by Hemming. Move back in front, picked up by Minton, and the captain sends it down the ice.
Danielson a little slow going off the ice. Took a hit to make that play.
6.5 to go here in the third period. Canada 3-1 lead. These teams last met in the gold medal game classic in Edmonton in August of 2022. Canada the overtime win, the golden goal. Scored by Kent Johnson after the miracle play by Mason McTavish on the goal line. In comes Newman with it. Tied up by Warren, they tangle in the corner. Allard tries to pick that free and does for a moment. At the line, held by Karki. Fed back and now poked out by Jaeger. In a race for it now, Jaeger coming in on the tired Artu Karki. 30 seconds to go in the Finnish power play. Newman slides that back for Kaskimaki. In comes Hellenius. He's watched by Matejczak. Played back around. Here's Newman with it. Behind the goal, picked up by Matejczak, but there's that long rim again. He can't get it up, but it's skipped off Hellenius and back out.
Caught a break there. Somebody's got to be telling him to handle that with time.
Newman works in with Hellenius and Hamanaho. No shots for the Finns on that power play. And the puck squeaks by Karki and back down the ice. A race for it. Savoy picks it up. In comes Matt Savoy and his poke check at the last moment by Pieniemi. Now Matejczak steps up. That's a Matejczak. He does not need an invitation to do that. Plays it back for Patra. Patra slides that towards the goal. Pieniemi took that away. Five to go in the third period. Pieniemi takes a whack there from Patra trying to knock it free. And now Karki has it back for the Finns. Around Patra, and that pass deflected away by Savoy. Bonk got caught flat-footed there, and a chance back in front for Bell. He's taken down, penalty coming to Canada. 4:42 remaining here in the third period. Macklin Celebrini, it took a long look, but yes, it was a Canadian goal and a 3-1 lead.
Tony Bet. At Tony Bet, get treated like a VIP, enjoying live gaming slots and lots of jackpots. That's what you get when you bet with Tony Bet.
Give the gift of adventure this holiday season with Yamaha's year-end sales event. Huge cashback rebates and great finance offers available now. Hurry, offer ends December 31st. See dealer or Yamaha's website for details.
At Kruger, we understand the power of assists. We wondered if kids do, too.
An assist is
kind of like helping people.
You can't have hockey without assists.
The Kruger Big Assist helps keep kids on the ice. Nominate your hockey association at KrugerBigAssist.ca.
One.
It's a trap.
Too many.
Go, 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 go.
Close. Calls. It's Nolan and the team versus a gang of hitmen on a new season of The Rookie, February 20th on CTV.
Canada just killed off a penalty. They'll have to do it again as Patra gets his, I don't know. I guess he sees the same replay I do.
Well, you know what? He got called for tripping in the first period. Didn't love that call.
But, I mean, he was around him and he dove and the guy bowed, fell. But he didn't really touch him. So a fifth power play, they just went 2 minutes without getting a shot on net.
Back with another face-off. Furlong trying to work that freight. There's Warren on it, off the glass and out.
Good work, get up on the glass, take your chances on those stanchions.
Artu Karki back for it. Setting up on the finished power play, which has had its chances. And the Finns scored their only goal in the man advantage in the second period. Kaskimaki works in, drops it off to Newman. Furlong with time.
Oh boy.
Off the stick of Minton and out.
You can hear the call of the time, but just shoot that one down if you have space. Don't need to pass it down.
Kaskimaki sets it up for the Finns, plays that back to Karki. Back to Hellenius. And Hellenius, with the scouts watching him. Across the Karki, hard shot by Newman goes just wide. Hellenius back to Karki, long shot to the leg, went off the leg of Kaskimaki and bounced right to Hellenius. Hellenius plays it back. There's another shot by Kaskimaki and back on the backhand sends it down and Canada will change. Coco thought about the quick up, but his teammates were changing as well. 40 seconds to go in Finland's power play. You wonder if the Finns would think about pulling the goaltender here late in this man advantage.
Would be inclined.
Keskinen for Lassila. Keskinen spins back, and Coco was inching out. Kilonomi plays it back, and here he comes. Kilonomi. Back for...
They called it too
oh
early.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, man.
They're going to call too many...
Not too many men.
Just an illegal change.
Premature change.
They're going to say the player came on too quickly.
So this rule is where you're not calling too many men is that the player jumping on for Coco jumped too early. So in theory, it's too many men, but I think they just blow it down as a too early change.
Illegal substitution almost.
Whistle, not penalty. So Coco's
Do I go? Here he goes. And I mean, wow. Clearly they're watching out for that, because that's a tight standard. I know it's not close, but.
We're at the middle.
And it's not a penalty.
Let's go. We're at the middle, right here.
Which is strange, because if it's too early, then it's too many men.
Yeah.
But there is a rule in place for this.
Yeah.
And I agree.
There is no circumstances on a change that you think someone's too far away.
Well, I mean, it's not like you got a break. He's just getting into the zone.
Yeah.
It's a break for Canada now. They get a face-off. If they win the face-off, they'll basically kill off the rest of the 21 seconds.
And the Finns are attacking up the ice.
At full possession in the offensive zone.
And now Coco wants some advice here as it's played back. Here he comes again.
That was the exact same change. Come a line and jump the same time. That would have been something if he called that twice.
Ooh, that pass back didn't miss by much. Lassila. Bob set back to Villeneuve. One shot for the Finns on the power play. Now fired on goal by Kupalainen.
You got three, you got four.
To Patra. Empty net. Scores! Matt Patra. Empty netter. And that gives Canada a 4-1 lead if it's onside.
We'll have to take a look. Patra dragged the foot. It looked really close. Unselfish play by Connor Geeky. He could have taken another stride. He could have taken a shot from before the red line. He makes a good hard pass. And maybe that little 10-2 opening. See, the Finnish players are calling for an offside right away. Now the puck crosses the blue line before it gets to Patra. So the look at his stick. Look at where his skate is when it crosses. That's going to be offside.
It's a cross.
Oh, that's good. That is good by a toenail.
I was going to say, maybe that is a shaving of a toenail.
That is, don't round off the steel on your blade. This will show you, slow it down. The 10-2 helps, and he's good. That is good by fractions of an inch. Timing's everything, Gord.
Put it this way, you can't be less onside than that.
Almost so close that it cut a higher percentage play would have been to string that out a little bit further, but that'll work. Patra gets his goal, and Canada will be up 4-1. And you think about this group, now Canada was with Germany and Latvia, setting themselves up to at least get a top two seed.
Right. It's interesting here. The host team in IHF events always plays in the main building. So the Swedes will play all their games in this building. They've made a provision for Canada because there's so many Canadian fans here. The Canadians will also play all their games in this building.
So if they were to finish third or fourth, they would usually have to move, but not now.
Now, moving in this case is across town.
Yeah, not a big deal.
And not even. It's 15 minutes away. There's Bonk with a long shot. That goes wide. Two to go here in the third period. Donovan played that back. Don't look to play it. Rakoff. That's hard. Into Salen. And again. Well, Donovan goes back. Stripped there by Manisto. And Tommy Manisto spins back.
Got a fresh leg. Only had a couple shifts in the game.
Koskipirti. Shot in front was blocked by Bonk. And Oliver Bonk spins back. Taken in hard there by Lassila.
Worked over by Lassila.
And Bonk goes right back at Lassila. They're continuing right in front of referee Tobias Bjork. And all the while the play continued. Hokkanen plays it back across. Fed in front. Hokkanen poke checked away. Rebound score. And Bonk took a bop at the end of that play. But Lassila, after the big tangle behind the Canadian net, moves out and scores to bring the Finns back within two with 1:04 to go.
There's Lassila. Did someone just grab a penalty as well? More importantly for Canada. It's calling for a change as Jaeger gets beat by Pulkkinen up top, and a little give and go ends up everyone broken down. Lassila grabs the loose puck and shovels it under the bar.
the plays made. Those are two defensemen going Salin to Kokkonen back and forth.
Team Finland, number 15, 2 minutes for roughing.
Now I talk, okay?
And now Pulkkinen gets the penalty after the goal was scored as he gets his gloves up on Bonk.
There it is there. And that's where you got to be disciplined. Like, if you're Oliver Bonk, you don't want to take that. You want to react. You get away with a little shove there. But now at least you'll get a penalty for Finland. Interesting. Timeout coming up for Finland. A couple things to digest here. One, if you're Canada, do you put out three forwards and two defensemen? I think you do. I don't think you go four forwards and one D. Now, I see four forwards and one D out there. I would not do that. I put out two defensemen knowing that as soon as Finland gets the puck, Coco's going back to the net and you're going to play this like a 5-on-5.
Right.
It's not going to be a power play situation. So know that Finland will press. They will jump. They will not sit back. And a second we get anywhere up the ice, Coco will come off. And so I see four forwards out there if I'm Canada. I don't like that. And it's a two-goal lead. But with only a minute left, Gord, I go two defensemen every single time.
We'll see if Coco comes here, because goal difference can be a big factor in three-way ties.
Right, they beat like if Sweden beats Canada.
Yeah, Sweden, Finland, Canada wound up in a three-way tie. Goal difference in the game between the tied teams matters.
Another element of this that you have to consider, and maybe another element you consider when you put on five a regular power play group. We want one more goal for goal differential.
Moves it ahead to Minton, slides it up for Geeky, Walker and shoots, and Coco got a piece of that. Celebrini hustles back, knocked that pass astray and pokes it back. Celebrini gathers it back up. Tkachuk's pass goes off a stick, bounces right in front. And Minton can't play it up. Coco's moving to the finish bench. Valenius shoots, it goes off a stick. As Dume got in the way of that, up and out of play.
Well, this is why you put two defensemen out there. You got broken plays, you got everyone swinging, looking for rushes. Just have two guys back there to play defense. Here Canada now with an offensive zone faceoff for Finland, of course. Yeah. You're going to get Bonk and Lamoureux out there.
And Allard to take the faceoff.
Lefty pulling it toward his goaltender.
One by the Finns. Valenius spins and shoots. That shot was blocked in front by Bonk for Lamoureux. Savoy couldn't knock it out. Here's Lamoureux back with it. There's that long clearing attempt again. Coco's gone back to the finished bench. That long shot stopped by Rousseau. Racing to it is Bonk. Lamoureux gathers it back up as time winds down. He's got an empty net. Scored! Nailed it from distance.
But that's not nothing. Yeah. That could matter. Smart play by Lamoureux. Hopefully everyone stayed onside to finish it off and get a fifth goal for Canada. We're still a three-goal winning margin. The big man.
The biggest man.
Who is full of personality. Yeah. A real one of those guys that adds life to a dressing room. Lots of jokes, lots of noise, and yeah, easily onside.
Right into the net camp.
And with what's happened to the defense in Canada with Luneau leaving and Molendijk leaving, Lamoureux played even more minutes, bigger role.
Intriguing guys. We mentioned a first-round pick by Arizona in 2022. That was the pick they got from Edmonton for taking on the Zach Cassian contract. But in the summer of 2022, he had shoulder surgery. His future is somewhat in doubt, but he's having a big year this year and has a big game today as Canada wins in 5-2 to take its opener at the 2024 World Junior. This game is being played in Sweden, by the way.
That's Shades of Halifax from last year. That was a very good game for Canada, really. I mean, under control, discipline. Saw a
the power play goal against and a late scramble against. Other than that, really clean. Russo, rock solid.
Yeah, some spectacular saves early on.
A massive save early on. And...